Hi everyone, I'm Courtney Bright. I'm the social and digital mediator at American Salon. I am so excited to be here in New York with Onco Tran today. He's going to be doing a live how to cut on me. I'm super excited for the tutorial and for the fresh haircut. So if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask them along the way. And I guess we'll get started.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, have a seat. I'm going to turn you around. So, I know you want to grow out your hair a little bit, so, and this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking that we should take off a good, like, you know, a 3/4 inch to make it nice and healthy. And I know you like the ends to be blunt, so I do like the blunt. But I also like it a little bit soft, so it has movement, so that's good. And then you have these pieces up here, if you can show them to me.
Sure.
It just needs blending.
I didn't cut that before, but it was previously, you know, done. So I want to take that up to about here, and then so it blends in with the rest. So it'll be a little more like on a modern shag kind of deal, and then relay everything. So give it 1 minute. Okay?
Perfect. I trust you. I'm excited.
Yay! All right, here we go. So I think I'm gonna start with the baseline first. Let's just do that later. I'm gonna layer first, something different. I'm gonna go ahead and give some layers in. I'm gonna start with the back and work my way towards the front, okay?
Cool.
And then I'm gonna start with the center. And basically working short to long. So I want a lot of layer that sits on top of here, so it gives her crown a little more movement, a little more a shag effect, but not like the full on 70s where it's like the crown is completely disconnected. And again, this is a little more of a softer modern shag. And the reason why I choose to do point cutting is that it makes her hair softer in the interior. So it moves better, and also it lays in better.
And we prepped my hair with a wash, but then we went ahead and blew it out.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you prefer to cut dry?
I like to cut dry because, one, I can see all the calyx. I can see if one side is thicker than the other, or, you know, after you layer it, you can see how it moves, you know? It's very important to see how, I don't know, I'm very visual, so I like to see how it moves instantly.
Yeah.
Instead of like cutting it wet, and just, when you cut it wet, you just basically give someone an overall haircut without any customizing. And then you dry it, and then you recut it again, so I want to cut that middle part out, and I know how my hair gets wavy, and I remember from last time I saw you came in. And so I have that in my mind, so I know.
Yeah. I have a lot of hair.
It's good hair. So when you do, when I do the short to long pieces, it will make the hair less bulky. See all these little guys, we can get rid of them. And let the part grow, and let the rest grow out. And then continue, Timmy, you want to come here, you can see it. Continue all the way through to the very front. A lot of times I like to keep the very front pieces out. You know, a lot of times you get like a really straight line. You want to make sure that, you know, your parting is really nice and clean. But in this case, I don't care about the cleanliness. I just want to make sure that her ends right here are covered and not that, it, you know, I don't want a hole right there. So a lot of times I just go in and I'd rather cover that. And then later on, visually blended. Okay, because I don't want no hole. Because she already has a little hole in the front, so don't want any more. All right, and then you take this up, and then you're gonna work your way short to long again. It's getting there. And then I'm gonna do the same on this side. So I'm taking pie section all the way through. working my way short to long.
Now, when you give one of your clients a haircut, how often afterwards do you recommend, do you schedule them to come in for their next cut?
It depends. If it's a really short pixie haircut, maybe 2 to 3 months. Your length, I would say about 4 months.
Okay.
Yeah. It depends. I mean, if they're like, if they're one of those type that like, I want to, you know, it just grow and it gets into different haircuts and it
right.
just, you know, form into another thing, then a lot of times they just let it grow.
Okay.
Until they get like really shaggy and they're like, okay, I can't do it.
I can't do it anymore.
Yeah. But I do have clients that like regularly that comes in like every 3 months. Like they want to make sure that they get the same haircut all the time. So it's good. I got both. I get, you know, people who just like let it grow and get to something else. And, you know, and one thing that's really good at when you do point cut these things is that it does lay in better. So it lays into each other instead of on top of each other.
Okay.
So when it does grow out, it just blends.
Okay.
That's the reason why I point cut. Jimmy, is there any questions on that?
No, we just got one actually. It says, what are Arn's favorite shears to use for dry cutting?
Oh, I love Hikaris. These are my favorite. They're amazing. They cut really well. They cut your fingers really well. They're super sharp. And the reason why I like them because they you don't have to get them sharp often, you know? It's an investment, but it's worth it. And they always yell at me because I like to keep my scissors really loose, and they hate that. Because,
really?
Yeah, it's not as good for the scissor in the long run. But these damn scissors are so amazing and so well built that it'll be fine. It'll be fine. And the reason why I like it really loose is because I don't put any effort on my wrist. Everything is on my thumb.
Okay.
So it's less work for me, and that's why I can do like 15, 20 clients a day, and it won't be, you know, painful already. So.
And is that a normal day for you if you're in the salon? 15
at least
to 15.
20? Wow. Yeah. Today is gonna be a late one. Yeah. So after I finish all that stuff, shake out the hair, just make sure that it's good and, you know, make sure the balance is good. I think I'm a little bit longer here, tiny bit.
Oh, and there's another question asking, does it matter how deep you point cut into the hair?
It does, it does. The deeper you go, the more weight you take out. So I'm gauging her hair because I don't want to go too deep, and that's not my whole thing, to like make her ends too thin. Is that, as you can see, there's certain points I don't point cut, there's part I do point cut because it's thicker and one is thinner than the other one. So you always want to point cut the way the thickness. So when you do have it down, it moves. And when you see these little points that comes in, those are point cutting. You won't get that with thinning scissors because thinning scissors will just make it look like thin and bulky at the same time. You won't get these pieces, you won't get these points. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just blending the top layer to the bottom layers. The other side of her hair was thicker than this side, so I'm just creating a little more movement that sits in the bottom. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the baseline. I haven't cut the baseline yet, so I'm going to take a good 3/4 inch off from the bottom. And I'm gonna point cut this, but not deep. So when you point cut this, it creates softness without being blunt, you know? Because a lot of times, like, well, why don't you just cut blunt and then point cut it? If you do cut blunt and then you point cut it, that it's gonna go shorter. So I don't want this any shorter than what it is. And then if there's a certain point that needs to be a point cut, I just go in a little deeper. And
I want to bring the sides back and over direct it back so it creates a little more of an A-line in front. Can I have you uncross your legs just to make sure that? The reason why a lot of people always have their clients uncross their legs is because sometimes when you do uncross your legs, you're like this, you know, or you're like this. But some people, when they cross their legs, they're like perfectly straight. So it all depends, you know. It's not like a rule of thumb, like you have to cut someone's hair with their legs uncrossed. Some people just cross it and they're like this. Like, you know, so it doesn't matter. It just, you have to, you know, make sure that the shoulder's not off when they cross their legs. So sometimes I have my clients cross their legs because I know they have it straight on their shoulder. But that's what we learned in school, is like, always let it uncross the legs before you start cutting. You know, I like to know the rules and then break it.
Right, and speaking of school, your classes.
Yes.
Can we talk about those?
Yes, absolutely. So we have Johnny and I, he's my business partner. He does beautiful, amazing color that just lasts forever. Him and I have our class, and it's called ART, Art, and it's Academy Ramirez Tran. And the reason why we have it, because we want to share our knowledge of like what we do and how we do things, you know, not just about hair, but just about, you know, the culture, you know, the social media, the how do you take photos, and what kind of camera we use, or, you know, what kind of lighting, and, you know, when to post, and all these information are so important, you know, and I think it's important when someone who doesn't do these things, and it's good for us to, like, share it, because it just, you know, it's time to share it with everyone else.
Absolutely. And where is your next class?
Our next class is going to be in Vegas.
Ooh.
Vegas, I lied, just kidding.
Seattle.
Just kidding, Seattle.
Check ya.
Because they have the same, no, almost the same day. I don't know. I travel so much, so I'll have to like ask my assistant. Timmy is filming it, he's my assistant. Seattle, is it September 19th? Yes, it is, okay, I got it. Yeah, September 19th. It's gonna be in Seattle. It's gonna be with L'Oreal. So L'Oreal has a thing up there, and then we're partner up with them, and so it'd be fun. It'd be really, really fun. I enjoy it because I used to teach, and I love it, you know, and I love it even more so because it's actually what I want to teach, you know, and it's fun, and I really love to share that with hairdressers. And
where can they go to find out about your upcoming classes?
They can go to academyramirezstrand.com, and then we also have Vegas class too, and that's in October. October 17th, yeah. Okay, right now I'm just getting rid of these split ends. So you see these little guys, I'm just gonna go in and just like get rid of it. Okay, I didn't take a 3/4 inch off, like barely. I mainly like maybe half an inch the most.
I trust you.
I'm actually on this the more on the shyer side when it comes to taking off length, because I don't know. I mean, I want to be honest. I'm not like one of those hairdressers like, oh, let's just take off an inch and take 3 inches off. I'd rather tell them the truth. I'm like, look, your hair is like crap. Let's take more off. Or your hair don't need it. You know? I think if anything, these internal layers, or these internal breakage, or not breakage, but like dryness that needs more attention than the bottom. Because a lot of times people only take the bottom up and then they forget the inside part. And the inside part is like the part that keeps on breaking, the part that keeps on like, you know, falling out. And that's important to like maintain that. So when you do, you know, get rid of these ends right here, it helps to maintain that. And I'm looking at, you know, hair by strand, not just like, you know, not just cutting random hair. Just check this out and make sure that's nice and even. So I'm gonna go now into the face framing, okay? And that's when I'm gonna go about. My aim is about the lip level.
Okay.
It goes all the way down.
Yeah.
Okay. Sweet. So my parting is like top of the ear to the front of the ear. Here you go. Okay. And I'm gonna elevate this. Let's see what quite point cut is. I'm not gonna elevate it high because the higher you elevate, the softer it is. The lower you elevate, the heavier it is. So I wanna bring it out just a little bit and then point cut this in because I don't want a blunt line. And the reason why I don't want a blunt line because the bottom here is soft. So if you have blunt and then soft, it just doesn't mix. So I'd rather have a haircut that mixes really well. That blends in well with texture.
There's another question. When did you start specializing in cutting in your career?
The funny thing, when I was in beauty school, all I did is just highlights.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. People just come in with like long ass hair and they're like, I want highlights. I'm like, ugh. I'm like, okay, I'm doing this so I can get points. And I got stuck with it. And, you know, one person liked it, the other person liked it. I suck at it. I'll be honest with you. I don't know why I keep on getting more. It's not my passion. I don't know. Color to me is so beautiful and I really appreciate it. And full respect for it, because without color, you know, the cut cannot be good. Without the cut, you know, the color won't be good. It just hands in hand, you know?
That's why you and Johnny make such an incredible team.
Oh, thank you. I mean, I think one thing is, like, he's so passionate about color, and I'm so passionate about haircuts. It's good, you know? If you don't have the passion of one or the other, it's hard. And I don't know. I can never do both. I can never do both. I get so stressed about color. Even toning extensions or toning people's hair, I'm like, okay, is it done? Is it looking dark? It's like weird, you know? I get so freaked out about it. But cutting, I can control it. I'm such a control freak when it comes to that part.
So how long have you been just cutting?
Probably about 15, almost 16 years. Yeah, it's fun. Every single year, every single time I cut someone's hair, I learn something, you know? And I would never stop learning. I'm never satisfied. See, like that, I can't cut that any shorter, and that's the previous thing that happened. So a lot of times, I just point cut this in so I can blend it. But yeah, I always learn, because you know why? Everyone has different texture.
Right.
And texture is so important to understand, you know? Even though a lot of times you guys see my Instagram feed, there's a lot of like haircuts that looks very similar, but keep in mind that each of them have different texture. So in order to make them look very similar, I think it's harder. It's hard to keep consistent, and I always try to be consistent. And I think one of the biggest complaints from clients is that consistency. A lot of times I always ask, like, oh, so why did you stop going to your last hairdressers, or blah, 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 blah. Or sometimes I get complaints too. I'm not perfect, you know. I'll be like, oh, hey, on your last haircut was great, but, like, you know, blah, 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 the time before, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, then I always think about, okay, how can I improve myself, and how can I get better? And how you get better is you create a system in within the haircuts. Either waiting it out or layers, all that stuff. Like, be consistent about it and know what to do when there's a curl back here or when there's a cowlick back there. Keep in mind, keep all that stuff in your head, and that's how you learn. It's when you're paying attention to the client's head. A lot of times I don't remember the name though, so but I do remember the hair. Once I get in, I'm like, oh yes, you do have a daughter that blah 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 blah, you know. That throws water balloons at people, whatever, stuff like that. They're like, how the hell do you know that? I'm like, I don't know, just got into your hair and I just remember that. So it's weird stuff like that, you know, but I just love this. This is so much fun, you know?
And you mentioned your Instagram feed and your social media. You've become such an influencer.
It's you know what it is? It's really fun to like be able to like always keep anew at things. And I think that excites me of all things, like keeping new, not doing the same thing over and over and over, like the same pose or the same style and stuff like that. I love the change. I'm a huge person about, you know, changing and stuff like that.
And if you had to give one tip to any of our audience right now on how to grow their following, they're like, oh gosh, you know, I look at On's page, how can I achieve what you have? What would you give them?
Be consistent. Again, consistent with your posts. If you know that you're going to be posting 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the morning, do it. You know, there's apps out there now that you can set all that timing, you know?
Right.
I still do it manually. And the reason why, because a lot of times I'll set it. I'll be like, okay, I'm going to post this one tomorrow, blah, 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 this one, blah, blah, blah. And then when I wake up to it, I'm like,
nah, you don't love it.
No. And at the same time, everything has to flow. It's like you're telling a story on your Instagram,
right.
You know?
Right.
So, I don't know. I think being consistent and knowing what you post, and I always like to show, you know, variations of like what I do, I don't just do one thing, and you know, and
a lot of your new clients, do they come from social media?
Yep.
Do they find, that's how they find you?
A lot, yeah. So, we just finished. A lot of times I like to blow dry with the cool air because I want to see what it looks like, I want to see the movement, and I want to cool my head down a little bit, you know, just like seal the cuticle.
This is great. I wish American Salon could hang out with you every morning.
I need that.
Yes, we do.
So, yeah, that's it. I really want this part to grow. I can't cut any more than this.
I won't trim it myself,
okay,
so it will grow.
Don't.
It will grow.
Because right now, as you can tell, this is more my liking on this side.
Right.
As you guys can see how it just flows. This one has a little bit. I'm very anal about everything. So, it will grow. I mean, with anything, like, when your hair does wave, it will disguise it.
Right.
So, but, you know, I know that. But next time, we'll come back and we'll just, like, get it more, you know, stronger and very fine.
Perfect.
So let's move in and waving here. I'm going to show you guys a new waving technique that I've been doing, and it's a different one than what we usually do, the lived-in waves. This one is a little bit newer, and I think it's more natural looking, because when you look at people's natural waving hair, there's some curls and there's some waves, so this has a little more of both in it. So, alright? And then Ramon's gonna come in and help me out. So a lot of times we tag team because we have so many kinds back to back to back. And also it'll help them to understand what I do, and also it's a training as well. So one, they get training. Two, you know, clients don't have to stay here for a while. And it's all a win-win situation. So.
And I think it's important for everyone to see this, because I know sometimes on the videos that are fast on Instagram, you know, people are like,
yeah,
oh, why does it take so many people? But there's a lot of effort that goes into the effortless,
yeah,
look.
It does. But some people have like the natural waves and it's just easy for them, you know?
Right.
I'm going to be using, actually, let's use an inch and a half, because I think her hair will curl well. So I'm going to use an inch and a half. Okay, make sure this thing's on. I love the Marcel. I know it's old school, and you know, and the reason why I like it, because you see this part, I can give it enough. I can give more pressure or less pressure. With the clamp, it's like you just clamp it and it just clamps, you know, it doesn't have any, you can't gauge it. This one you can make it, you know, if someone has thick hair, I can like really push it down and give it more pressure. So that's the reason why I like it. And you can do the same with the flat iron, with this, you know, with this wave that I've been doing. But I like this one a little more because it's more consistent. The flat iron, you know, if you make it, if you go too fast, then it would be too wavy. If you go too slow, it would be too less wavy. So being that consistent is hard, you know. With this, it's like, I think it's easier. You're just bending in and out. And that's it. So it goes in more like that. And then the next one, I want to use the old live-in waves. Okay. And Ramon's doing the same effect too. Tim, you want to come over here and take a look? So I did this part already, as you can see. So you get that part, and then you get that. And when you do mix it, it blends in really nicely. Okay, and then this next one, I'm gonna be doing the new one.
Every other?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then this one. Okay. So sometimes it goes in, sometimes it goes out. And, you know, I like it a little more natural looking. Or I'm inconsistent in that sense, you know? And then this very last part, I'm gonna go back.
Now, do you teach other styles in your salon this technique, or
mm-hmm.
do they kind of form their own technique?
I do. If they ever wanna learn it, we're always like, hey, you know, I got this new thing, blah, blah, you guys should try it, blah, blah. And then a lot of times are like, yeah, I wanna try it, you know? I mean, they got the other one down, so.
Right. And how many styles do you have in your salon?
As of now, we have about 24.
Wow.
It's a lot. It's a lot.
Have you done a class yet in your salon?
Not really. No, we have not done that. We haven't done that, but we will. We just haven't got a chance to, like, you know, really sit down and do LA or New York. The reason why we're teaching in different cities is because we got offers to do different places, you know?
Right.
So, and it comes easy, so we're like, why not?
Well, it's great because there's artists everywhere.
Yeah. And also, you know, finding location and all that stuff is really hard, you know? Something that can host, you know, like 70, 80, 90 people is hard.
Is that what you try to keep your classes to?
About, you know, because it is a look and learn.
Right.
So it's no hands-on. Hands-on, never. Oh, that's too many people. But look and learn, yeah. I think, you know, we can do that because you will have like about a good amount of four models coming in, and you know, there's variations of length of hair cuts, and you know, and they're pre-done models with color and stuff like that. So it's there's a lot of variety, a lot to learn from. And not only that, it's just like there's a social media segment, and there's like all these different segments.
Which is so important. And for anyone that's joining us right now on, can you let them know where they can sign up for your classes?
Yeah. AcademyRamirezTran.com. Okay. Or you can go on to one of our Instagram. We always, you know, have that on there.
And where can everyone find you on Instagram?
My full name, Ankotran. A-N-H, though. Don't spell A-H-N. You won't find me. So the only part that gets a little tricky once you get back here is like alternating. And do the same.
sing and we're almost done.
See how fast it is? Great, you guys are like the dream team.
Yeah, every morning we'll come to your place.
How great would that be? I'll bring you coffee.
Okay. Fair enough. Gives you that second day hair. It's second day hair. It's really cool.
That's the best kind of hair.
Agree. So I want to have you put your head back. Spray this in. All over, maybe on the roots.
It smells really good. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you get that a lot.
A lot. It's one of my favorite products right now. It's just so good. You know, what we're doing, it just suits it. So now you can see how it blends. I like to use a bit of a cream on the bottom for more separation on our ends. Okay. And the one I use is, you can just, let's do that photo right now. That's the one I use on the ends to give it more separation, to piece it out more. Hair's a little thirsty.
Yes.
We can do a little more. Okay. There
you
go.
Hey. I need to go make dinner plans.
Yeah. I think the rain stopped.
That's the worst.
I know.
Cool.
Just gonna soften up these pieces. I don't like them too curly. But it's better to do it too wavy.
Right.
And then you can soften it. You don't do it wavy enough and it won't be as it won't hold as much. Julio.
Hey!
Yay! Alright. Do you have a shirt underneath?
I do.
Good. Let's take that off so you can see the whole entire thing.
So for those of us that are just tuning in, you can always see this on replay at American Salon Facebook page. Oh, I love it!
Right? It's blunt at the end.
So good.
It's soft, too. And you can see the movement and all that stuff. It's just, I like it.
Thank you.
Better?
Yes. Yay. So thank you all for tuning in. And again, you can always come back to Facebook to see the replay. Anka Tran, thank you for joining us. Where can we find you on Instagram?
Anka Tran.
That's all. Yeah. You can find American Salon on Instagram at American_Salon. We also did a little prep on our Instagram stories. You can catch that there. And we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Take care.